Photography has an unflexible eye compared to our natural eye, which is focusing in a split second. Yeah? And also adjusting to the light situation in a split second. And with photography it doesn't work. And I tried to take this unflexibility to turn it into an advantage. So in filmmaking I also put the camera on the tripod and I wanted to have the stare which is sociologically, which is not accepted in normal life. Only little children stare and animals can stare, you know, look for a long time. But if you do it as a grown-up in the bus or in a train, you will be very suspicious. You can try, I try it sometimes. You can try out if you're courageous. You can try out to stare at different people. I mean, not look away, just look. Yeah? Beautiful women, very dangerous nowadays. Yeah? Strong men, very dangerous. It's a little bit reality cinema. I never write a script. I don't have a script, not a producer, not assistants, and no post-production. With Max Turnheim, I had in one film a post-production because I wanted to add the voice of his newborn child. But I didn't know that it will be an ongoing project. I didn't have it in mind. But in the first film, I touched his hair. I left the camera, which was on the tripod, and touched his hair and then went back. And then I had a record of his surprise and his emotions and his thinking, why does she do this? She has the age of my mother. Why does she caress me? And things like that. The next year I thought, now I will take his family because I need to show for his psychological state, I need to show the family he comes from. And then it went on. Then after some years he had this girlfriend and then he changed the girlfriend and then he got a child. And so now it's going on and I expected any year that he would say, it's enough, let us stop. And for me it would be okay if we stop. I have only one assignment when I film. All the years through I have one assignment, only look into the camera, nothing else. But then sometimes I leave the camera and I do a kind of actionistic, like undressing, some surprise. I do some surprise, which is kind of stealing. It's a kind of criminal act, in fact. I feel very guilty because I steal some emotional reaction from the model, which the model wouldn't have given to me otherwise. The artist they are forced somehow to invent legends, legenden. So it is not an invention what I tell you now. I don't think it's an invention, but I'm not sure. I was standing as a little girl with my mother in Vienna. So I was maybe 5 or 6, and she was talking to a woman up high. She was a tall woman, my mother, and she was talking to another woman, chattering. Much too long for a child, you know. I didn't want that. And then when they finally said goodbye, I said to my mother, who was this lady? And she said, she seemed to be a nice lady, but she is not. And this, so it is only an example, a little bit how I was brought up with my mother's psychological insight or way of thinking or perceiving the world. And if you have this several times, of course you start, you also start to look at people and what is behind the facade. My psychological interest comes from there, from education of my mother, like the culture in the house, but maybe not.